so you'll know, information we shared in the last class is pretty much out of here and out of here. I just look around the room and I see different people that I'm involved with over different circumstances and things. And there's a tendency sometimes to think that because I'm aware of something or this or that, that I'm speaking to that. This truth applies all the time and forever. If you need to be spoken to about a certain situation, personally, I would probably come to look for it. But I'm not really good, and I don't like to never do the innuendo or the hidden message that. First of all, I don't think that's a good way to proceed. The night the world is dark, what I mean is that you have to do it good. Number one, I'm really not that good at it.
But I'll tell you what feels good.
by preaching about the situation. Here's what I found. They get worse. Really. But I mean, they get worse. And I found the best thing to do is just preach Christ as much as you can without any no hidden agenda in your heart, no religious authority in the Lord. You know what I mean? I mean, religious, your heart really is just to share the Lord, and your heart really is today. If you could somewhat present it in a way that they might be able to receive it. That's it. And you will succeed. And what they do with it, or what God wants to deal with, whatever, is history. So, and not only that, but at that time, the Lord told me, don't ever do that again. The Holy Spirit. Don't ever do that again. And he said, it doesn't work. Preach Christ, not the prophet. entire building up here this month. Ready to bust. If you open a little valve, well, the real answer would be to get the fire out so that it's not boiling, right? But Jesus is the answer to that. But the Creator, God, the Father, God, the Son, God, the Holy Spirit, I believe is built within us ways and means to keep us from this world. I think all of them are going to get back to the Lord. shocking, but if I told you some of the trends, I would have been horrible. But nonetheless, they were young. Especially because I'm really trying my best to follow the board and everything. The last thing I need to do is wake up in the morning feeling trashed and dirty, from which I'm not cleaning it. And she said that because it was more than that thing. I felt dirty. And I tell you another reason why I believe Jesus the devil. None of this is based on scripture, so nobody has to believe any of this. I'm just telling you my, this is just an experience. I'm good citizen, they don't know what I'm feeling. But the second class is going to be a real one of our kinds.
Wrong.
yourself long after that just because you're just a creator of the word. Now, you don't have to have a, you know, devil to cause you to walk in the truth or to want the truth. Just walk in Christian, you love the truth. So, you know, I'm the creation, and then they come back later and hit you, and you go, I'm the new creation. I'm the sinner because you walk in. You got it. You're building. You're working on it. I mean, really. It's like somebody who's working out, man. At first, you know, kind of turn that takes place here with the emphasis on the South. And these are the things that we're going to be exploring in next year, actually. And to me, the most that I have seen in relationship with the South that I've seen right here is just how good really open to me is understanding. And it's funny, I mean, it's his understanding because these Pharisees were accusing Jesus of misusing the Sabbath, and he's God. They're accusing God of not knowing what the Sabbath is all about. So I think he knows. And I think that any interpretation we have is going to be fall way short of the boundary. And I know that that's true of any knowledge of anything. That our understanding, you know, his ways are not our ways. And his ways are so far above ours that we have to go to him and go, you know, here's what I was thinking about it now. Can you tell me the real way it is? You ever do that? I have to do that regularly because, you know, when I talk about, you know, I discount my thinking more than yours because I'm more aware of it. My thinking apart from the Lord, it's I think sometimes it's even good, but it just it's nothing. Very cool. Understand that relationship has very told me that he was going to send the Holy Spirit, the Father would send the Holy Spirit, and he would be with me, guide me to altar, he would lead me, and he would do all this stuff. And so I trust the word of Jesus, so much so that it's built in me now, so much so that I trust Jesus anymore. I have trusted Jesus, and I looked at the Holy Spirit, and I may look with eyes of concern, because I know that I can easily fail. I may look, I may be fearful even in my emotions at that moment. But behind it is true confidence that you are the Holy Spirit and have been given to me. Guide me, not just me, but you guide me also to the other life. And you are with me and you never leave me. I believe that. So I believe that. Now that's not just, I believe that the doctrine of the Holy Spirit that when he comes, he will never leave. Do you understand? Because a lot of people believe the doctrine that when the Holy Spirit comes, he doesn't leave. They believe that doctrine. But when they sin and mess up, they feel separated from God and they don't rely on him, believing that he's there and relating to you and wanting him. The only way that you can be let out of that situation by the Holy Spirit. He came to you when you were totally in sin and against God and moved on. Isn't that? That's how you accepted the Lord. So why would he be any less now when you're at least a child of God? You know what I mean? So we have this doctrine, blue blood. Amen. You hear that? You have the other priests that turn, believe that the Holy Spirit will never leave. And then you counsel with them next week and they go, why are you so afraid? Oh, it's bad. It's all bad. But he came down here, and it was his choice. He's with us. He's with us through. He's leading, he's helping, he's guiding, he's a comforter, he's a guide to all truth. He is the Spirit of truth. And that's, I've got it. And down here, I've got to have the source of truth over my word now. I've got the Holy Spirit. And I don't faint when I'm pressed with hard. I mean, like I said, I get concerned. And you know, I get concerned. I go through stuff. But the anchor is that the Holy Spirit will eventually work through this situation. And it's done so many times that I know it will. But therefore, I do have a deep trust in the divine presence of the Spirit and that he will fulfill what Jesus said. Would I give you the truth that I need to know? He will lead me and he will tell me things to come if I need to know those things. And I actively love him. See, that's, I don't have a lot of description of what the Holy Spirit has done. So what I do have, I go, the word of the Lord, and really just be some preeminence of the word. The word of the Lord said here that this is how my relationship is supposed to be. The word of the Lord is preeminent in my life, and therefore I expect and have faith that our relationship is thus. And you know what? Yes, that really is.
should do it. I'm ignorant. But I know how to listen to the Holy Spirit. And so I went to the Holy Spirit. He said, you know, this is him. So he said, I said, you know, you don't have a lot of money. Whatever, you know, they're asking this, what should I do? And he didn't always answer this way, but he says, ask for this, you know, but this is the promise. This is what the price you need. Okay. Something happened, and I don't even remember the whole story, but you know, and when I said it, we stood right over there, then you and him stood right between us and right there with that great council, and I said, well, I'm willing to offer you so-and-so. And that wasn't the last time. When the closing day came, other things had come up. Closing costs, and this and that, all this stuff came up. It was added in. And so the day that we were to go to the title company to sign it, we were $5,000 off the mark. And God told me, ask him for $5,000. And we met at the Grandy's, we had Grandy's just before we rolled over. We met at Grandy's, and I said, well, I feel like the Lord told me that I'm supposed to ask him for about $5,000. I went like, I'm confident, but you must go with the Lord. I feel like I'm trying to obey the Lord here. It's your money, it's your bill, whatever. This is what I feel. I said, I feel like the Lord, I feel like we need to cut $5,000 off this. And he got up, I don't think he said anything. He got up and went to the restroom. I don't know what happened in his pants before, but I don't know.
Thank you.
then it will bring a tremendous amount of rest. And I believe that that is rest for your soul. Rest for your soul. And that's not the only aspect of rest. That can bring rest for your soul.
Yes, it's for qualified stuff here. I just want to make sure, you know, that it's spoken as a success. I'm going in that deal an hour before closing and bumping the thing for 5 grand is the fact that you will be God. That is the success story, not the fact that we pay $5,000 less.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I know you're saying this, but I'm just speaking this.
Right.
Because I'm not correcting you, obviously, I know this. I'm just speaking this. Because the fact of the matter is, to do that is highly unorthodox and borderline to unethical.
Right.
To go above for you 5 grand and half an hour before closing, half you already have a deal. But because,
and then of course I'll say we'll pay whatever, but I just feel like I have to present.
Sure, but because it was the Lord, that's the success. And that's why it bore witness to His Spirit, and that's why it happened. And once again, I must speak to you, I'm speaking of this out. And in the same situation, the success might be when you know you don't have 5,000, so to speak, for God to tell you to go ahead. And you go ahead, and that bears witness to you.
Walk in the meeting and offer $5 more.
Well, because you've done that.
Yes, I have.
I know you have. For different things, when people have said, I'll give it to you for this, you said no, and you bumped them up. You know, because it was the Lord who used so. Because I've personally witnessed that. And so I just wanted to speak the fact that the success is born of the Lord, and not, you know, money up
and down. I appreciate the clarifying, because it is so hard to cover all the bases. I'll give you another example. Sunday morning, Carol Ann had mentioned that she liked prayer or whatever for relationship to her clippers that she cut through this character. And I've seen her clippers because she's cut my hair many times, and I knew exactly the kind they were, and I had been to CCA and bought the exact pair. When I bought them, I bought them out. Very, very expensive compared to what they bought. When I bought them, I didn't know hers were having a problem. It was the exact same company. I didn't know hers were having a problem. I bought them thinking, because I know Nisi and I know Deb and stuff, and I knew Caroline's hands were getting worse. It was hard for her to do it. So I thought, well, you know, when I brought home, and he said, well, that's really cool, because I don't know if you have noticed, but the girl that's got my hair, and he said, just have to watch it. So in my mind, you know, I'm going, well, you know, maybe this will help her when she'll have to do some lines to be serious for a deaf client, and then they can keep, because I can really shag it out in front of people a lot, you know, so maybe this will cut down on the length of time I have to go, and all this kind of stuff. So this is what I'm thinking. Get all this stuff, but then we're sitting in service, and she says, so they went out and they put it up, and I sat down and choked. You know, you can get up and kill or something, but I got the exact same thing. And, well, okay, you know what I mean? And I try to listen, I try to really hear from the Lord. I mean, you know, because you got any number of things that you can mess with. And so I just waited patiently, and, you know, and then finally the Lord gets me. To get those things. And then in my mind, then I saw the paper. Hers were breaking down. I didn't know it. Here they were at CCA. They're very expensive, inexpensive. It's exactly the kind she needed. And how wonderful the Lord is to set it up and provide for her to do this thing. Okay. So I walk up and I said, well, you know, CCA, and there was a response from some people on one, and I don't know if they did this, but I sensed a response that made me come home after the day. Why? Well, bless God, I that it don't matter if it's in my heart or not, if God's glory gets robbed, that's a big deal. It don't matter. You know, I can make a problem here, and I know the power is better than I just, you know what I mean? But I want to cross all the truth. Me first. And then I realized, oh, yeah. And you know, the only deal is I could have been more careful wording it so that God would be on the floor, but I just was trying to just throw it out like this. So, and you know,
really want to stay right in your spirit. Lord, that never keep you in the place of providence. That see your plan. That have given their time, given their energy, your plan, which is not a ministry, but is Christ in us. And you work first in us, and then in others, so that you would all